Welcome to this how-to video from cBioPortal. In this video, I'm going to highlight some new features that enable you to add any clinical data element to the Mutations tab and also filter on individual columns. To get to the Mutations tab, we're going to run a query. Here, I'm selecting a lung cancer study, this one here, and I'm going to query for EGFR. Submitting the query brings us to OncoPrint, where we can see that 30% of patients have an alteration, primarily mutations. So let's click over to the Mutations tab and look at those mutations in greater detail. We can see quite a few recurrent mutations in the lollipop plot, and the one I'd like to focus on is this one, T790M. Now, we've always given you the ability to click on a lollipop here, and it will filter the table below. But what I'd like to highlight now is a new way to filter directly on a column in the table. When I hover over a column, you can see this gray filter icon appear. If I click on it, I can now filter this column to just the values I'm interested in. You can see that we provide a number of ways to define your filter, but I'm going to stick with the default and filter to just the T790M mutations. Notice that the filter icon is now blue to indicate that a filter has been applied to this column. If we look at the next column over, we can see that according to OncoKB, these T790M mutations are associated with resistance to a number of EGFR-directed therapies, which raises the question, did these patients receive anti-EGFR therapy? Well, let's see if there's a clinical attribute that can tell us. Here, in the columns dropdown, there are options to add additional data to this table. Recently, we added all the clinical data, so all the same data you see in study view, all of that can be added here. So I can search to see if there are any therapy-related fields. And I'll go ahead and add targeted therapy. Here's that new column added, and we can see that all the samples currently in view did receive a targeted therapy. We can continue to scroll through the table, or we can actually come back to this filter feature, which also serves to summarize the data, and see that every patient with a T790M mutation has received targeted therapy. Depending on your questions of interest, you can add additional columns of clinical data or apply filters to multiple columns at once. We hope you found this video helpful. If you have additional questions, please check out the other resources listed here or reach out to us by email.